Then the action is complete, dear ones. You have returned to the will of God, surrendered into the will of God in this moment, and you feel love, and there is no need to act. Although the fear have made you think that you ought to act to change the situation, when in fact love was the solution, and the situation changed as soon as love was created. As soon as you returned yourself to the conscious awareness of yourself as love, no longer being manipulated by the unconscious thoughts of fear and your identification with a limited self. Now, dear ones, as this experience of peace and love in which you are, during this experience, a desire may rise up from within you, from within your heart, rising up within your physical body, within your energy field of consciousness. And it may encourage you to act. This divine guidance will move you into action without needing to speak a word, without needing to enter into your egoic mind at all. For if you are centered in the moment, action will happen through you effortlessly. For you, when in a surrendered state, are in harmony with the will of God that is creating all of life. People think, dear ones, the will of God comes from a judger, from a being that sits above the world, commanding people to act, commanding people to do the will of God, commanding people to murder, commanding people to be cruel, commanding people to judge. This, dear ones, is only an idea of a creator that is separate from all of life. This is an idea, dear ones, and this is not the direct experience of life when you choose to surrender into life as God, as the creation of God, being created within God and by God, being created from God and as God. There is no separation within the oneness that is God, although the judging mind may believe a God to be separate. Yet this belief in a separate God with a separate will imposed over mankind is only stemming and only exists within the egoic will of the individual. An individual who thinks themselves as separate, who believes themselves as a separate person, may create an idea of a separate God within their thinking mind, and they may choose to act in this world, proclaiming their motivation by this separate God, proclaiming their will to be superior and all other wills to be wrong and inferior. Yet this, dear ones, is only a disguise within your judging mind. For the will of God exists as life, as pure experience, as pure expression. There is no need to judge. There is no need to separate yourself from life, for in doing so, you are believing yourself to be separate from God. When in fact the truth remains, there is only oneness, there is only one God, and there is nothing separate, nothing at all separate from God. It is only your judging mind and your feeling of separation that believes God does not exist in all places, does not exist in all times, and God does not exist as all forms. No, dear ones, the truth remains as eternal, that God is life, and everything is God. All distance, all space, all time, all form is God. One life, one being, one consciousness, existing without separate, without qualification, simply existing as pure experience. And the will of God, dear ones, is creating this world. The will of God is creating you in this moment. The will of God is manifesting all the change within the form of life. So surrender into this, and know that you will be guided to move. You will be guided to act. You will be guided through God, within peace, never leaving the experience of peace, never leaving the experience of love. And your thoughts, dear ones, your thoughts may stem from the will of God, for the thinking mind is not separate from God. And your thoughts, dear ones, if united, if creating within love, within peace, if these thoughts are creating from that place, allow them to guide you, for they will continue to create peace and love within your experience. The thinking mind is part of the manifest world. It need not be pushed away. It need not be judged as being separate from God. It need only be understood as one aspect of manifestation within the will of God. And as you choose to surrender into God as all life, you will know true peace, you will know true love, and you will live in alignment with the will of God moving through your body, moving through your thoughts.